In San Francisco, we can virtually bring the city to a standstill, but now we can move across the country, and by doing so, we make each other stronger.
So what's the message today?
Message is, look out. Here we come.
According to Kinsey, one out of every 10 of us is a homosexual. It used to be that it was something to hide. But last October, the homosexuals of this country publicly proclaimed themselves to be the newest legitimate minority. They did it just like all the others before them, with a march on Washington.
All right, get it!
They came from every state in the Union to deliver what they felt was an historic message.
America, we are some of your best friends. We're some of your best relatives. Your sisters, your brothers, your mothers, your fathers, your daughters, and your sons. Listen, America, in the 80s, we are moving from gay pride.
For someone of my generation, it sounds a bit preposterous. Political power for homosexuals? But those predictions are already coming true. In this report, we'll see how the gays of San Francisco are using the political process to further their own special interest, just like every other new minority group before them. Gay power, gay politics. That's what this report is about. It's not a story about lifestyles or the average gay experience. What we'll see is the birth of a political movement and the troubling questions it raises for the 80s, not only for San Francisco, but for other cities throughout the country.
For the average person, it may not be dangerous to go into this park, but when we came here with our camera crew, a group of gay men surrounded us and forced us to leave. A week later, we came back without our crew, but with a home movie camera. This is what we found. From sunup to sundown, men everywhere. Hundreds of them coming to this park each day for public sex.
We went up there and we saw a stripper, and another man which was with him said if we told anyone, he'd beat us up.
For the gay men of San Francisco, cruising in Buena Vista Park is done without shame. Their sexual encounters here are guided by a ritual that calls for anonymity. The men don't exchange names. They barely even talk as they follow each other into the bushes for sex.
We were trying to take a shortcut home, and I thought that maybe a path would bring me down the hill. And when we saw these men all doing strange stuff.
What do you mean, Laura?
Well, one didn't have his clothes on, and then all the rest were looking at him.